Hello, and this is principal update number two. Okay, principal update number two. Today I want to show you that we have created a very long list of questions and answers of questions or statements. I don't know how that's focusing for you. All right. And we have 5 pages of it. And we're not going to go through all 5 pages today. Don't worry. We're going to cover the first two, and because one of them is a pretty big issue. Actually, we might cover the first three. Number one is, if you feel sick, don't come to school. If you're presenting the symptoms of COVID and you have those symptoms of COVID, do not come to school. Call your healthcare provider. Find out if you need to come get tested. They may tell you no. They may tell you come in, you need to get tested. But if you're carrying on a temperature, if you are having shortness of breath, if you've lost the sense of taste and smell, if you are nauseous, if you have a sore throat, those are all symptoms of COVID. Now, there are symptoms of other things as well, but you let the doctor decide that. And we're encouraging you, do not come to school if you have symptoms. Now, I'm wearing this mask, and it's not fun to wear a mask, and I know that's not fun to wear a mask. And I'm going to take this mask off now, all right, because I want to tell you about masks at Ethel. Yeah, masks. The question I get mostly is, Mr. Newman, are we going to have to wear masks at school? And I know the beautiful people of Ethel do not want to cover up the beauty that they possess. And I don't want you to have to do that, okay? And you're not going to have to wear a mask. I'm not making, no one in Talley County is required, has to wear a mask all day long. But it's recommended. Why is it recommended? Well, Dr. Dobbs and many others in the CDC and the healthcare profession, they have told us that if you wear a mask, you have a better chance of not passing along the COVID virus if you're an asymptomatic carrier and you don't even know you have it. You're better off with a mask because you can't pass it. And if you wear a mask and your friend wears a mask, you've even doubled up the possibility of preventing your friends from catching it. Now, that's one good reason. But the second is this. If you're at school and one of your classmates gets COVID, they test positive for COVID, they get sick, all right? If you've worn your mask during that class, that you're in class with that classmate, you won't have to go get tested. We're going to notify your parents. We're going to tell them, hey, your child's been in class with a student who is tested positive, and we want you to know that, and please be aware of that and watch for the symptoms, but you will not have to be tested if you've worn a mask. If you don't wear a mask, we're going to ask you to be tested. And if you don't get tested, you're going to be out for 14 days. So you can get tested and come back and let us know positive. Or if you go to the doctor and they tell you you don't need to get tested, that's up to them. But if you see a doctor, we'll go that route. Second thing is that there may be a teacher. We have a couple of teachers who have immune systems that are compromised. And those teachers will require you to wear a mask. If you don't wear a mask in that class, you won't go into that class. You won't be in trouble. We're going to take you to a distance learning location where you can carry out the same class you would if you were in the class. But if you do wear a mask, you can't go in. We're not going to compromise the health of an immune compromised teacher because it's not comfortable to wear a mask. It hurts my nose, and I got a big nose, and it looks better when it's covered up. It's not fun to wear a mask. I can't breathe with a mask on. I understand all those things. I'm sitting here talking to you with no mask on. And why? Because no one else is in the office. I'm all by myself here. Okay? So, what I want to encourage you to do is wear a mask. Why? Because I think you should care more about the health and well-being of your classmates than you care about your own comfort. I think you should love your neighbor as you love yourself. That's what I think. I think you should do those things for to think about others over the thinking about yourself. Okay? So I want you to know that we're not going to require a mask, but we will require that you have your temperature taken every morning. So every morning when you come to school, you're going to get your temperature taken when you get on the bus. When you get off the bus, before you enter the school, we're going to take your temperature again. And we got the thermal scanners that we take a temperature, find out. And if you have a temperature, you're going to be going, giving a phone call, say, hey, you got to go home. If it's over 100.4, if you have a temperature of 100.4 or greater, you're going home. Because it's one of the symptoms, and we that's the standard we have. So we want you to let you know that. You don't have to wear a mask. Don't come to school if you feel sick. Take your temperature before you come to school. That way you know. And if you have a temperature of 104, you won't be staying at school. Y'all have a great day, Ethel Tigers. We're going to get some more of these. We got another of these to go through. We want you to be aware of them. If you have any questions, again, email me, cnewman@atala.k12.ms.us. Thank you and have a great day.